Greetings to all. I welcome you all to my zoology class, lesson 12, Trends in Economic Zoology, part 3, Animal Husbandry and Management. Animal husbandry is the practice of breeding and raising livestock, cattle like cows, buffaloes and goats and birds, etc., that are useful to human being. Parameters such as adequate ventilation, temperature, sufficient light, water and proper housing accommodation should be taken into account to maintain dairy and poultry farms. Animals should be cared and protected from diseases. Records should be maintained after their regular visits by veterinarians. Moreover, the selection of good breeds with high yield potential, combined and resistant to disease, is very important. Animal breeding. Human beings have been depending on animals and animal products for food from very early times. Generally, high yielding animals produced by hybridization are rare in poultry and dairy farms. In earlier days, animals were produced and selected based on specific characters. With the gain in knowledge on the principles of heredity and genetics, human beings have been successful in rearing animals with the superior qualities through hybridization experiments. Complex issues are faced by the animal breeder during hybridization experiments. Hence, animal with maximum desirable character should be selected. A group of animals related by descent and with similar characters like general appearance, features, size, etc., are said to belong to a breed. Why should we breed animals? Through animal breeding, improved breeds of animals can be produced by improving their genotype through selective breeding. Objectives of animal breeding: to improve growth rate, enhancing the production of milk, meat, egg, etc., increasing the quality of the animal product, improved resistance to disease, increased reproductive rate. Methods of animal breeding. There are two methods of animal breeding, namely inbreeding and outbreeding. What is inbreeding? Breeding between animals of the same breed for 4 to 6 generations is called inbreeding. Inbreeding increases homozygosity and exposes the harmful recessive genes. Continuous inbreeding reduces fertility and even productivity, resulting in inbreeding depression. This can be avoided by breeding selected animals of the breeding population, and they should be mated with superior animals of the same breed but unrelated to the breeding population. It helps to restore fertility and yield. Outbreeding. The breeding between unrelated animals is called outbreeding. Individuals produced do not have common ancestors for 4 to 6 generations. Outbreeding helps to produce new and favorable traits to produce hybrid with superior qualities and help to create new breeds. New and favorable genes can be introduced into a population through outbreeding. Outcrossing. It is the breeding between unrelated animals of the same breed but have no common ancestry. The offspring of such cross is called outcross. This method is suitable for breeding animals below average in productivity. Crossbreeding. Breeding between superior male of one breed with superior female of another breed. The crossbred progeny has superior traits, hybrid vigor or heterosis. Then next one is interbreeding. Outcrossing. Interspecific hybridization. In this method of breeding, mating between male and female of two different species. The progeny obtained from such crosses are different from their parents and may possess the desirable trait of the parents. Have you heard about mule? It was produced by the process of interspecific hybridization between a male donkey and the female horse. Control breeding experiments. Artificial insemination. Artificial insemination is a technique in which the semen collected from the male is injected into the reproductive tract of selected female. Artificial insemination is economical measure where fewer bulls are required and maximum use can be made of the best share. Thawing. Thawing means to melt or become liquid. When the semen collected for artificial insemination is taken to far off place or stored for a long time in frozen condition, it should be brought to room temperature slowly before use. This process is called thawing. Advantages of artificial insemination. It increases the rate of conception. It avoids genital diseases. Semen can be collected from injured bulls which have desirable trait. Superior animals located apart can be bred successfully. Multiple ovulation embryo transfer technology, MOT. It is another method of propagation of animals with desirable traits. This method is applied when the success rate of crossing is low even after artificial insemination. In this method, follicle stimulating hormone is administered to cows for inducing follicular maturation and superovulation. Instead of one egg per cycle, 6 to 8 eggs can be produced by this technology. The eggs are carefully recovered non-surgically from the genetic mother and fertilized artificially. The embryo at 8 to 32 cell stage are recovered and transferred to surrogate mother. For another round of ovulation, the same genetic mother is utilized. This technology can be applied to cattle, sheep and buffaloes. Advantage of this technology is to produce high milk yield females and high quality meat yielding bulls in the short time. Breeds of dairy animals. Dairying is the production and marketing of milk and its products. Dairy operation consists of proper maintenance of cattle, the collection and processing the milk and its byproducts. There are 26 well-defined breeds of cattle and 6 breeds of buffalo in India. Cattle are classified under 3 groups based on the purpose they serve to man. They are dairy breeds or milk breeds, draught purpose breeds, dual purpose breeds. Dairy breeds or milk breeds. They are high milk yielders with extended lactation. Example, Sindhi, Gir, Sahiwal, Jersey, Brown Swiss, Holstein cattle. Draught purpose breeds. Bullocks are good for draught purpose. Example, Kangayam and Malvi. Dual purpose breeds. Cows meant for yielding more milk and bullocks are used for better draught purpose. Example, Ongole, Haryana. Breeds of dairy animals. To meet the milk demand of the growing population, milk breeds are preferred by farmers in small-scale farms. Goats are also used all over India for supplementing deficiency in milk production. Some of the breeds of cattle that are good milkers are Jamunapari in Ganga Jamuna River tracts, Beetle in Punjab, Barbar in Uttar Pradesh. Breeds of dairy animals. Vekur breed is the smallest breed of the cow as per World Guinness record. Average length 124 cm, height 87 cm. Origin, Vekur village, Kottayam district of Kerala. It produces large amount of milk in relation to the food consumption. Common disease of cattle. A healthy cattle, a healthy animal can eat, drink and sleep well regularly. Healthy cattle appear bright, alert and active in their movement with a shiny coat. Cattle are affected by large number of diseases. Cattle in ill health appear dull, restlessness, change posture frequently with drop in milk yield. The main diseases of dairy cattle are rinderpest, foot and mouth disease, cowpox, hemorrhagic fever, anthrax. Uses of dairy products. Milk products, meat, land management, manure. Milk product. Milk is produced by dairy animals, which is an emulsion of fat and lactose. Milk also contains enzymes, which are destroyed during pasteurization. Milk is a rich source of vitamin A, B2, B1 and deficient in vitamin C. Due to its high nutrition value, it serves as a complete food for infants. Dairy products such as yogurt, cheese, butter, ice cream, condensed milk, curd and milk powder processed from milk made dairy a highly forming attraction. Meat. Meat is rich in protein and also contain many minerals like iron, zinc, vitamin and selenium. It also contains vitamins needed for human diet. Land management. Grazing of livestock is sometimes used as a way to control weeds and undergrowth. Manure. Manure can be spread on an agriculture field to increase crop yield. The next is poultry farming. The World word poultry refers to the rearing and propagation of an avian species such as chicken, ducks, turkeys, geese, quail and guinea fowls. The most common and commercially found birds are chicken and ducks. Poultry farming is essential for the purpose of meat, eggs and feather production. Commercial poultry farming is also profitable. In this part, we are discussing about an overview of chicken duck breeds, farming practices and its advantages. Types of chicken breeds. There are more than 100 breeds. The commonly farmed chicken breeds are categorized into 5 based on the purpose for which it is farmed. They are egg layers, broiler type, dual type, game type, ornamental type. First one, egg layers. These are found mainly for the production of egg. Example, Leghorn and Chittagong. Leghorn. This is the most popularly commercial breed in India and originated from Italy. They are small, compact with a single home and wattles with white, brown or black color. They mature early and begin to lay egg at the age of 5 or 6 months. Hence, they are preferred in commercial farms. They can also thrive well in dry areas. Chittagong. It is the breed chiefly found in West Bengal. They are golden or light yellow colored. The beak is long and yellow in color. Ear lobes and wattles are small and red in color. They are good egg layers and are delicious. Second type, broiler. They are well known for fast growth, soft quality meat. Example, white Plymouth Rock. White Plymouth Rock have white plumage throughout the body. It is commonly used in broiler production. This is an American breed. It is the fast growing breed and well suitable for growing intensively in confined farms. Dual purpose breeds. They are for both meat and egg production purpose. Example, Brahma. Brahma, it is a breed popularly known for its massive body, having heavy bones, well feathered and proportionate body. P. Hompi is one of the important breed characters. It has two common varieties, namely light Brahma and dark Brahma. Game breeds. Since ancient times, special breeds of roosters have been used for the sport of cockfighting. Example, Asil. Asil, this breed is white or black in color. The hens are not good egg layers but are good in incubation of eggs. It is found in all states of India. Asil is noted for his pugnacity. Pugnacity means fight, high stamina and majestic gait and dog fighting qualities. Although poor in productivity, this breed is well known for their meat qualities. Then the fifth one is ornamental breeds. Ornamental chickens are reared as pets in addition to their use of egg production and meat. Example, Silky. Silky, it is a breed of chicken as a typical fluffy plumage, which is said to feel like silk and satin. The breed has numerous additional special characters such as black skin and bones, blue ear lobes and 5 toes on each foot, while the majority chickens only have 4. They are exhibited in popular poultry shows and come out in various colors. Silkies are well recognized for their calm, friendly temperament. Silky chicken is especially simple to maintain as pets. Types of poultry farming. There are different methods used to rear both broiler and layer chicken. The types of poultry farming are free range farming, organic method, yarding method, battery cage method, furnished cage method. Among this, battery cage method is widely used in large scale poultry farms. The free range, organic and yarding method are eco-friendly, and the eggs produced by each farming practices are preferred in the market. Stages involved in rearing. There are some steps involved in rearing of chicken. They are selection of the best layer, selection of eggs for catching, incubation and catching. Selection of best layer. An active, intelligent looking bird with a bright home, not obese, should be selected. Selection of eggs for catching. Eggs should be selected very carefully. Eggs should be fertile, medium sized, dark brown shelled, and freshly laid eggs are preferred for rearing. Eggs should be washed, cleaned and dried. For incubation and catching, the maintenance of newly laid eggs in optimum condition till catching is called incubation. The fully developed chick embryo emerges out of egg after an incubation period of 21 or 22 days. There are two types of incubation, namely natural incubation and artificial incubation. In the natural incubation method, only a limited number of eggs can be incubated by mother. In artificial incubation, more number of eggs can be incubated in a incubator chamber. Brooding. Carrying and management of young chicks for 4 to 6 weeks immediately after catching is called brooding. It can also be categorized into two types, namely natural and artificial brooding. Cousing of poultry. To protect the poultry from sun, rain and predators, it is necessary to provide housing to poultry. Poultry house should be moisture proof, rat proof, and it should be easily cleanable and durable. Poultry feeding. The diet of chicks should contain adequate amount of water, carbohydrate, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Poultry products. The main products of poultry farming are eggs and meat. In India, the primary aim of poultry farming is to obtain eggs. The eggs and poultry meat are the richest source of proteins and vitamins. Poultry byproducts. The feathers of poultry birds are used for making pillows and quilts. Droppings of poultry can be used as manure in fields. The droppings are rich in nitrogen, potash, and phosphates. A number of poultry byproducts like blood meal, feather meal, poultry byproducts meal, and catchery byproduct meal are used as good source of nutrient for meat producing animals and poultry. These byproducts supply protein, fat, vitamins, and good amount of minerals. poultry diseases, rinitis, coccidiosis, fowl pox are some common poultry diseases. Benefits of poultry farming. The advantages of poultry farming are it does not require high capital for construction and maintenance of poultry farming. It does not require a big space. It ensures high return of investment within a very short period of time. It provides fresh and nutritious food and has a huge global demand. It provides employment opportunities for the people. Chickens communicate with more than 24 vocalizations, each with a distinct meaning, including warning their friends about different types of predators or letting their mothers know whether they are comfortable. Duck farming. Duck is the aquatic bird and forms only 6% of our country's poultry population. There are about 20 breeds of ducks. The native one include Indian runner and Shailet Mecha. The exotic breed include Muscori, Pekin, Aylesbury and Campbell. Domesticated ducks have been derived from the wild duck named Mallard. Scientific name Anas boscus. Farming duck is profitable as it can be combined with aqua farming practices. Peculiarity of ducks. The body is fully covered with oily feathers. They have a layer of fat under their skin which prevents it from getting wet. They lay eggs at night or in the morning. The ducks feed on rice bran, kitchen waste, waste fish and snails. Types of breed. There are three types of ducks depending on the purpose for which it is farmed. They are meat productive duck breeds, egg productive duck breeds, breeds for both meat and egg production. Advantages of duck breed. Duck farming. They can rear in small backyards whether water is available and needs less care and management as they are very hardy. They can adapt themselves to all types of environmental condition and breed for feed efficiency, growth rate and resistant to diseases. Okay, that's all.